Hi, my name is Clyde Yancey. I am a former president of the American Heart Association, and I'm here to speak to you about something very important to many people who rely on the American Heart Association for trusted, valuable information about heart disease. One of the most important heart conditions we deal with today is something we call heart failure. You as the layperson may know it as congestive heart failure, or CHF. Let me tell you, this is an important consideration. About 6 million Americans have this disease as we speak, and about 1 in 5 Americans over the age of 50 is likely to develop heart failure during the rest of their lifetime. So this conversation isn't about somebody else. It's about us. It's about you. It's about me, our family members, and our friends. The reason that the American Heart Association is making this statement to you about heart failure now is because we're in the midst of an explosion of options that can fundamentally change the experience for patients with heart failure. Yes, we have already, through research that the Heart Association has supported, demonstrated that many strategies are very beneficial for heart failure. Drugs, devices, even approaches with patient education to really reduce the need for hospitalization, prolong survival, and help patients feel better. But as a doctor who takes care of these patients, I know that sometimes we come up short, and not every patient derives the benefits we want. Our patients, you, your family members, need more options. More options have come about. And so now is a great time to have a conversation with your doctor and understand what therapy should you receive for heart failure. So let me help you a little bit. Let's define heart failure. Heart failure means that your heart function is no longer capable of supporting your needs. That seems like a pretty generic definition, but it's just that plain and simple. If you have shortness of breath when you try to do things because of heart disease, that's heart failure. If you are accumulating fluid because your heart is either too weak or too stiff, that's heart failure. Heart failure, like every other disease, comes in stages. They can be mild heart failure, moderate, and severe heart failure. We have specific names for that, but what's important is to remember that it's not all one disease. There are different kinds of heart failure and different stages, and you know what? There are different therapies that are appropriate for these different stages. The future in heart failure is now, because we have great therapies that we can give you, and you don't have to be frustrated. You don't have to feel like it's a futile effort. I can assure you that we have much experience now prolonging survival, restoring quality of life, and helping patients feel better and helping their families feel more comfortable and more secure with heart failure. So the future right now are all the therapies, considering the new therapies that are now available. But the real future is in two directions. One direction is understanding how we can use really cutting-edge therapies, biological therapies, building new hearts with cells. We think we can get there. It's going to take some time and a lot more research, which is the strength of the American Heart Association, to champion that research. But the other thing we know is that we can now talk about preventing heart failure. Yes, we can prevent this from happening. We know better how to screen patients. We know better how to identify the risk factors and try to reduce the burden, the impact of those risk factors. Again, it's all about having a conversation with your physicians.